In this video, we'll be exploring the science behind butterfly pea flowers. To do this, we'll be walking through some of our labs that use butterfly pea flowers and explaining what occurs and why. We highly recommend that you do the labs before watching this video. Butterfly pea flowers are actually very similar to red cabbage in that they can be used as a pH indicator, meaning they change color in response to pH. And that's because, just like red cabbage, butterfly pea flowers contain anthocyanins. Anthocyanins are actually found in a wide variety of plants, like beets, blueberries, cherries, and hydrangea flowers, which are particularly cool because we can actually influence their color by changing the pH of the soil. Blue, purple, and reddish hues are often hints that these molecules are present. These molecules are pigments and can be different colors depending on the pH that they are exposed to. If you feel like you need a quick review of pH, check out our other video linked here. Essentially, these anthocyanin molecules interact with hydrogen ions, and when they do so, they absorb or reflect different wavelengths of light, resulting in different colors. Keep in mind, we're only showing one molecule, but these solutions are made up of hundreds of molecules, which is why we see a spectrum of colors as the pH changes. Additionally, anthocyanins are actually a large group of similar molecules, so there isn't just one exact type, but there are hundreds of different ones. We can think of these anthocyanin molecules like crayons. Imagine a box of crayons of different colors. That's pretty much what's going on with our anthocyanin molecules, but we have a gigantic jumbo box of hundreds of crayons. Most things will be made up of at least a few different crayons or molecules. This also helps explain why there are some differences between red cabbage and butterfly pea flowers. If you've used red cabbage before, you'll know that red cabbage is purple at a neutral pH, but butterfly pea flowers are blue. This is because they're made of slightly different anthocyanin molecules. Okay, let's move on to our tea that we make with the butterfly pea flowers. Originally, the tea is blue, and that's because the butterfly pea flowers are in a neutral solution, which is water. When we add something acidic to the tea, like lemon juice or citric acid, the pH drops. As we add more acid, we'll notice that the drink continues to get more pink, indicating that the pH is still dropping. Now, in one of our labs, we add in baking soda after we've added in citric acid, and we'll notice an additional color change. It becomes blue again. That's because the pH is now rising because baking soda is basic and has a pH of around 8. The other key thing we'll see when adding in the baking soda is bubbles, and that's creating a carbonated fizzy texture. These bubbles are indicating that a chemical reaction is occurring. Acids and bases like to chemically react in a neutralization reaction. So we have the citric acid reacting with the baking soda, which produces carbon dioxide gas, which we notice as those bubbles. Additionally, when they react, a neutral product is formed because they're kind of canceling each other out. So the pH is becoming closer and closer to 7, assuming that we've combined them in an appropriate ratio. Okay, so to recap, butterfly pea flowers are a pH indicator because they contain anthocyanins, which change color in response to changes in pH. Originally, we added hot boiling water to the flowers, which is a neutral substance. When we add in something acidic, like lemon juice or citric acid, the pH drops. Then when we add in baking soda, which is basic, that pH comes back up. All right, that's it for today. We hope you enjoyed this episode of Bite Sized, and be sure to like and subscribe for more videos.